Welcome to Bite Size UGC, where nothing worth doing takes more than 3 minutes. I'm Kirk Fatt. With me as usual is Captain P.F. Dennis. This show marks our 20th episode. There have been many ups and downs.
That's right, Kirk Fatt. And tonight's review of Becoming the Enemy's Friend by Logitech 007 has both. Let's begin with the story. You are sent to Romulan space to discover what happened to ships and personnel lost in previous failed missions and to confirm the identity of their inside man. After meeting a couple of admirals and collecting intel, you proceed. I could do an entire show on the grammar and spelling in the dialogue. It made it difficult to understand the plot at times, but that is so easily fixable.
My favorite part of the mission involved a fight between my bridge officers. I also appreciated some character tweaks in the beginning, like an ensign challenging me to racquetball. However, as the mission went on, it was increasingly difficult to follow the plot, simply because the space battles, combined with lots of unnecessary dialogues, made it difficult to remember what I was doing and why I was doing it. I appreciated what the author was trying to do as far as leaving little clues that built up to a conclusion, but with so many prompts, like my bridge officer saying the ship has been destroyed after I see it blow up, it was distracting from the plot. We gave story 3.5 stars. On to map design.
Maps were well done in my view. I liked the internment camp particularly. Overall, the mission had a nice look to it that only strengthened the atmosphere.
I also appreciated some of the details of the maps, especially the sickbay with so many beds and NPCs. The scenery for space battles was also very solid. Many of these may have been cryptic-made maps, but they were all very nice. We gave map design 4 stars out of 5.
Now on to tech. Pretty standard stuff here. I wish Logitech had included a way for the player to pick off the enemies in the guard tower, like from a distance requiring a sniper rifle. Lots of potential there.
You can tell that this author wrote the mission in a word processor and then discovered the severe limit of dialogue button responses. But instead of dealing with that limitation, the author had my bridge officers speak for me in my first-person voice. This was highly distracting and confusing. It makes me wish that Logitech could use a costume for the player. But without that feature, it was not a good workaround in my opinion. Might we suggest using Prop Federation Console for the contact with a different color font? Tech got 3 stars.
Finally, difficulty. I could just edit in an enormous sigh here. Difficulty was, well, insane. Every map had you up against battleship-level mobs in space, and the final room of the Romulan base was absolutely unwinnable. With several commander-level mobs with medics galore, you just could not kill them. Normally, you could chip away between respawns, but there was no respawn point near the room. Once dead, you had to start at the beginning of the map. By the time you got back to the fight, medics had risen the dead. I didn't complete this mission.
I also didn't complete the mission, but for a different reason. I had an easier time with space combat by spawning my hollow fleets with a science ship, but for me, it was fun up until a point when it became overkill. If you love space combat, then you should enjoy this mission, but I found it tedious. Difficulty got 2.5 stars.
And here's the bite-sized breakdown for Becoming the Enemy's Friend by Logitech 007.
Support the Foundry by playing these missions for yourself. Remember, tip generously.
This has been episode 20 of Bite-Size UGC.